Okay, in last class we discussed many cases, and in this class we thought to do problems, but I will explain this active earth pressure cases for cohesive soils and passive earth pressure case for cohesive soils, and later we'll do all problems at a time. Okay, now that here that Rankine made some assumptions. The first assumption was the soil is a homogeneous and isotropic and semi-infinite, and the second one he considered a dry soil and a cohesionless soil. Okay, and here and some other assumptions are there which are already discussed. Here, if a soil is not dry, if a soil is a moist, if a soil is saturated, if a soil is submerged, then what happens? That we already discussed in the cases. Now we need to discuss if soil is cohesive soil. If a soil is cohesive soil, then what are modifications or how we need to deal with the problems that we are going to study today. Okay. Now we'll consider cohesive soil. Cohesive soil means what? That is, C is not equal to 0, or we can say C is also present and phi is also present. Therefore, we will give a name, general name as a C phi soil. That is C phi soil. Means your sand mixed with silt and clay, or gravel mixed with silt and clay, or silt and clay mixed, or pure clay, or pure silt, or combination of these four, in any other combination, in any form of the combination of these all four, that is your C phi soil. Okay, no? Now let us consider a retaining wall. This is our retaining wall, and here this is our cohesive soil. Now this is our cohesive soil. And active earth pressure we are considering means what? The wall, that retaining wall, is allowed to move. And active earth pressure means what? Here this is moving away from the backfill. Wall of the that retaining wall is allowed to move, and this is active case means it is moving away from the backfill. When it is moving away from the backfill, already it is moving and movement is allowed, means the equilibrium condition here I am considering plastic equilibrium condition. Right, a plastic equilibrium condition I have to consider. What is that condition states? That is sigma 1 is equal to sigma 3 tan square alpha plus 2c tan alpha. 2c tan alpha. Okay. If it is an active case, then if I consider a small element here, then the vertical stress will be sigma v and the horizontal stress will be sigma h. And in the previous class, that in the previous to previous videos we discussed that in active case sigma v will be more than sigma h. Therefore, more means this is a major stress, therefore it is a major principal stress, and this is your minor principal stress. Okay, no? Then I will substitute this sigma 1 equal to sigma v, sigma 3 equal to sigma h in a plastic equilibrium equation. That is, this is your sigma h is equal to, sorry, sigma v is equal to sigma h tan square alpha plus 2c tan alpha. Now in this case c is not equal to 0, not equal to 0, therefore this term is not equal to 0. In a previous case we made this into 0, but now this will not become 0. Okay, here this is a lateral earth pressure, means we are interested in sigma h only. Therefore I want sigma h. Send everything that side, sigma v minus 2c tan alpha is equal to sigma h tan square alpha. Right? I will write it reverse. Sigma h tan square alpha is equal to sigma v minus 2c tan alpha. I will take this tan square alpha this side, sigma h equal to sigma v divided by tan square alpha minus 2c tan alpha divided by tan square alpha. 1 by tan square alpha I can consider cot square alpha, and this cancels. Therefore, I can have sigma h equal to sigma v cot square alpha minus 2c cot alpha. This is the equation. This is equation for, that is your sigma h equal to, that is a horizontal stress. Okay, here sigma v means what? Sigma v usually we calculate by gamma into h. That I am writing sigma v only. I will not write this gamma into h here. Wherever it is required, I will write that. Okay, no? Now this equation we are going to use for this one from top to bottom. From top to bottom. Now if I think about a point A. Point A means what? That is h equal to 0. Now at a point A, what is the sigma v? That is the vertical stress I need to calculate. Look at here. Sigma h. Now I will substitute. I want that, therefore gamma into h cot square alpha minus 2c cot alpha. Okay. At A means what? H equal to 0. Means sigma h equal to, that is becomes the first term becomes 0, then you will get minus 2c cot alpha. Minus 2c cot alpha. This I got. Okay. Here very interestingly, this is a negative means. In geotechnical engineering, all the stresses are in positive because we consider positive stress means compression. Therefore, here you can see that is a negative I am getting here. Means the sigma h at top we are getting negative means that is in tension. Means the top surface is subjected to tension force. How much it is? That is 2c cot alpha. This much of tension stress is there here. If this is my reference line, then I am getting here tension. Okay, no? Now as you go further and further, for example, if I consider this, some one rough example I am going to give you, that is sigma h equal to some x plus minus y is there. This is x minus y. And here in this case you can consider from the top to bottom gamma is constant, and from the top to bottom alpha is constant, because phi is constant, alpha is constant. From top to bottom c is constant. Means this sigma h equation is varying with respect to h. Means the first term is a variable and the second term is constant for a particular layer. Means if I consider here this one, like this is at the top 0 minus y means something, you take 5. As you go deeper and deeper, h will increase means this become 1. But what about the second term? That become 5 only. Then what is the answer here? Minus 5. This is a minus 4. Now this is increasing. The first term is increasing. Then it is minus 5 only, minus 3. And this is again increasing. Like that, 4 it becomes. Minus 5, that is minus 1 only. Means at a particular time when it is increasing from top to bottom, it will get a some point there, it become 0. And after that, as this become a positive value, plus 1, plus 2, you know, plus 1, plus 2, like that. Means from this we can consider that when one term is a constant and one term is varying, then at a particular point this sigma h become 0. Okay, let us consider that sigma h becomes 0 at a particular point like this. Here it becomes 0 and it will increase as it is. And this is again a straight line, because the h power is 1 and dependent variable power is 1, linear equation. Okay, no? Then now I become interested here at this point. What is this point where I am getting sigma h equal to 0? That I want to find. Therefore, what I do, I will purposely consider that sigma h that is equal to 0 at a particular point. That point I will consider that as a h t. I will tell you later what is the meaning of t. Okay. Now h equal to h t, then sigma h equal to 0, then this equation becomes what? Look at here. 0 equal to gamma into h cot square alpha minus 2c cot alpha. Then here gamma into h, this h become ht, cot square alpha equal to 2c cot alpha. 1 cot cancels, and therefore ht equal to 2c by t, and this cot alpha comes, 1 by cot alpha becomes tan alpha, tan alpha. This is a ht. Then why this t is there here? Sorry, h gamma it is. 2c by gamma tan alpha, right? That t indicates tension zone. Okay, here this is your ht. Why? Because this is a tension, tension, tension. Like that, it is a tension zone. It is a negative in direction. Okay, means tension zone is there here, and it is reducing, reducing, and it becomes zero at a particular point ht. Then I calculated that ht equal to 2c by gamma tan alpha. 2c by gamma tan alpha. You know, that is why, and even this ht, you can call it as a h crack. H crack means depth of cracks. Then what happens when the soil is in tension? You need to think about this one. When the soil is in tension, then the soil want to, so that stress is pulling the soil, means when it is pulling, means it will become a cracks. See, the soil will yield some cracks at this point. Means that is the depth of the crack. How much here at the top, maximum tension is there, therefore the width will be more. As you go deeper and deeper, the width will reduces and becomes zero. Why this becomes zero? Because the tension is reducing and getting to zero. Therefore, this I can call is a depth of cracks. HT is your depth of crack, or HT is a depth of tension zone. Understood? And after this one, the soil will be subjected to compression. Now again here, one very interesting parameter will come again. That interesting parameter is, see, the total earth pressure in the tension zone will be the sum PT. PT. PT, but the direction is in this direction, rightwards. Then the same amount of the triangle, the same thing if I consider here, means if I go same HT height below, then I will get one more triangle here. This triangle is obviously positive triangle because this is the compression, and but this area and this area is same, means here one stress I will get. This is your P. P, I will call it as a PT dash. Okay, sorry, we will consider PC only, PC dash. Okay, now this area and this area is same means what? These two are equal. Then up to this level, up to this level, active earth pressure is becomes zero. Up to this level, the active earth pressure, because this is a minus and this is a plus, the sum of these two triangles becomes zero. Therefore, the active earth pressure up to this level will not be there. Means this retaining wall is not required up to this level. Means only retaining wall is required for this level. Then why it is not required? If it is not required, then I will construct a retaining wall like this. Look at here. A retaining wall will be constructed only this much height, and the soil can retain this much. See, the soil can be like this. Then why this soil is not falling down here? Because it has a cohesion inside. It has a cohesion inside, and the top soil is a tension and bottom soil is in a compression. Therefore, these two will that together they will hold the soil till this one. Means up to this level, the retaining wall, the support is not required. Therefore, this height we will call it as a H critical. H critical. Then what will be the H critical value? The H critical value will be H critical. Will be equal to 2 times H tension zone or H cracks, that is 4C divided by gamma into tan alpha. That is your HC. Means HT is what? HC is the depth up to which the support, lateral support, is not necessary, not required. Understood? Then what about the bottom? Okay, this is over. And what about the bottom? Bottom will be the entire equation. That entire equation, what it says, that is sigma h at bottom, that is h equal to capital H, that is equal to gamma into capital H cot square alpha minus 2c cot alpha. This will be your total. Okay, no? Then here that diagram, you can draw it like this. That is a retaining wall. This is a retaining wall, and this is a point, interested point A. There is a tension zone, and this is your reference line. we got it like this, right? Then up to this height, the retaining wall was not required, minus, and this is the plus, therefore cancels. Therefore, you can calculate the total pressure P will be equal to, this is a P1, but it is a minus P1 plus P2 plus P3. Or you can consider this is the entire thing is a P2, then you can consider this is a P2. We'll make like that only. Okay, we'll not make two things and we'll have a P2. Okay, this is a P2. This is your total pressure acting on the retaining wall. Okay, and even sometimes in some textbook they will calculate it like this, that a retaining wall, the active or pressure distribution for the retaining wall will be only this much. Only this much only if you calculate, that is also fine. This is also a P, then that is also P. Both are equal. This diagram and this diagram both are equal. Here I shown tension zone and compression zone, both I have shown and calculated, and this minus and plus it took taken care and I got the answer. But here I avoided that showing that diagram and I got this one. Okay, and once again I will come to that diagram. We'll discuss one more very important parameter, that is, this is a reference line and this is earth pressure distribution. Okay, I will draw two diagrams. One at this point, this is a negative and this is a positive, and this is a positive, entire positive. Okay, see this diagram, what it tells is there is a tension stress at this point. There is a tension stress and the stress is reducing and becomes zero and become a compression, and becomes a compression here. Okay, what it exactly tells is the top soil is getting tension, but there are no cracks. Cracks are not developed, but they are ready to develop it. They are ready to develop it, but I am not allowing. How I am not allowing, I don't know whether this retaining wall is there or some surcharge is kept on that one, or some building is built, something, some arrangement is made, and this soil is not allowed to develop the cracks. When this is not allowed to develop the cracks, then the total active earth pressure acting on the wall will be the entire diagram, positive, negative, including all. When it is, when cracks are not allowed to develop. Think that the top soil, there is no surcharge, there is no building, and this top soil is free to develop its cracks. Then when the soil is allowed to develop the cracks, then it will develop it. When it develops, then there won't be any stresses. There won't be any stresses. This you have to keep in mind. Okay. For example, if I give you one rope, you know, I ask you to pull from the either end, then you will pull it. This rope has not cut, still it is not broken, then there will be tension inside the rope. Once the that rope is broken out, then there won't be any tension in the rope. The same thing here, the cracks are already developed or allowed to develop, means there won't be any tension. Then your active earth pressure acting on this retaining wall will be only the bottom big triangle. Therefore, in examinations or otherwise in a practical, there are two chances that active earth pressure calculation, that is total active earth pressure when before crack develop, and active earth pressure, total active earth pressure after crack develop. Before crack develop means you need to get the tension area and compression area all, and when you want after crack develop means you need to take only the bottom area, bottom big triangular area. This is your active earth pressure case in case of cohesive soil. When you come to a passive earth pressure in cohesive soils, then what happens here? Look at here. This is my retaining wall. It's a backfill, and now it is a passive earth pressure, means what? Wall is moving towards a backfill. Some arrangement might be there here, and because of that the wall is moving towards the backfill. And if I consider a small element here, this is sigma vertical stress, sigma horizontal stress. In passive case I will be having sigma h greater than sigma v, therefore sigma h becomes a major principal stress and sigma v becomes a minor principal stress. Then plastic equilibrium equation, if I write sigma 1 equal to sigma 3 tan square alpha minus 2c tan alpha. Okay, then here sigma 1 means it is sigma h, and this is your sigma 3 means it is sigma v into tan square alpha. Tan square alpha minus, oh sorry, it is plus 2c tan alpha. Okay, this is the equation, end here. Because sigma h, that what I wanted, therefore sigma h equal to this is the answer. Then if you come to the cases, what happens here at the top point A? A point means at h equal to 0, at A means h equal to 0, then you can consider the sigma h equal to, this is your gamma h, this is your gamma h, therefore this becomes 0 plus 2c tan alpha. Here we are getting positive means top surface is subjected to compression. The top surface is subjected to compression. Okay, how much? Look at here. This is your compression. That is your 2c tan alpha. 2c tan alpha. Then as your h increases, then at the bottom, at B, that is your h equal to capital H, then your answer sigma h becomes gamma into capital H tan square alpha plus 2c tan alpha, the entire thing. Therefore in the diagram I will show this one linear variation. Okay, now you can deal with the trapezoidal, or you can make it into a rectangle and triangle. Then this will be your p1 and this will be your p2. Here there won't be any cracks because there is no tension zone here, there won't be any cracks. Therefore p1 plus p2 is the total p, and you calculate a z bar from the bottom where that p is acting. Okay, this is all about active and passive cases in the cohesive soils. Okay, thank you. In the next class onwards, actually this is over, a retaining wall theory is over. Now we need to solve problems, and after that later we will make some videos on graphical theories, that is Raibans, Kalmans and Coulomb's theory. Graphical theory, we will make some other videos. Next class we will solve problems.